Puna Tuesday. Tonight is Tuna Puna Tuesday. But Tuna Puna people, which your MP said represents a microcosm of Trinidad and Tobago, are warm, embracing people. So we have your neighbor tonight. He first entered the parliamentary chamber as an opposition senator. Following the start of the collapse of the government led by Calamity Kamz and her band of two merry men, St. Joseph resoundedly voted for him in the by-election of October 2013. He again received an overwhelming mandate in 2015 when he was once again re-elected as the Member of Parliament for St. Joseph. He was subsequently named the Minister of Health. And tonight, to report to you on the performance of the Ministry of Health, to report to you on how the PNM is getting it done, let us welcome the man who brought us healthy balance with Terrence, the Honorable Terrence Dayalsing.
Stand up for your right. Get up, stand up.
Good night, Tuna Puna. Tuna Puna Tuesday it is. Dr. Keith Christopher Rowley, political leader of the People's National Movement and Prime Minister of the greatest little republic in the world, Trinidad and Tobago. The Honorable Camille Robinson Regis, my leader in the House, and MP for Aruka Malodi and Minister of Planning and Development. Let's hear it for her. The Honorable Esmond Ford, MP for Tuna Puna and Deputy Speaker of the House. Let's hear it for Esmond. Chairman of the different corporations, councillors, candidates, come on, candidates. My colleagues, MPs, cabinet members, ladies and gentlemen, we are in the corridor. How you like it? Yeah. You look wonderful in red. And let me just remind Esmond, he was telling you all the people in Tuna Puna who do this, who do that. Esmond, what is Noriega's best bowling figures? You called out Noriega. 9 for 95 against who? Against India. 9 for 95. And that is what we're going to give Kamla. 9 at your Rukatung. Ladies and gentlemen, I am going to report to you tonight on what your PNM government has been doing as far as the health sector is concerned. What we are doing in the corridor from St. Anne's to Toko, and I'm going to make a stop all the way. Starting St. Anne's, I'm going to stop in Digo Martin, St. James, Port of Spain, Mount Hope, Arima, Cora, Sangre Grande and Toko, to tell you what your government under your Prime Minister has done. I want to start with something. The best Kamla Prasad Bisesa has to offer you in the corridor is a man called Tupul. That is the best. A recycled failed politician. But let me tell you what we have to offer you. Your government has started a serious policy of decentralization of mental health to Trinidad and Tobago, to bring mental health services to you in the communities. What that will mean, we are going to shut down St. Anne's and build a brand new mental health facility with satellite centers all around the world. Tuna Puna has one already. Takarikwa has one already, to make mental health services more freely available to you. That is policy. So I started in St. Anne's. I'm going to stop now in Digo Martin. Digo Martin, anybody from Digo Martin here? Miss Ward, look at senior there. Miss Ward, you are getting your new Digo Martin Health Center between August and October next year. Long promise. That is for you. So you see the corridor? We're coming down. Next stop on Imaxi, Port of Spain. Kamla Prasad Bisesa sat on a report that said Central Block is seismically unsafe. Close it down. What did she do? She built Kuva. She ignore everybody. Anybody from Port of Spain here? Yeah? This is for you. We are turning the sword soon for a brand new 540-bed tower in Port of Spain. That is your government. That is performance. Kamala was negligent. She didn't care if that building fell. She didn't care about you. But with that will come 3 years of construction jobs. Then you have more jobs for nurses, more jobs for doctors, more jobs for attendants, more jobs for biomedical people, more permanent, well-paying jobs in addition to jobs during construction. That is progress in the corridor. That is for Port of Spain people. That is for Diego Martin people. St. James, we, the Honorable Prime Minister, in January of 2020, will be opening for the first time in the history of Trinidad and Tobago a linear accelerator. What does that do? Delivers radiation to treat cancer. The first one in the public sector in St. James. Your Prime Minister will be opening that. So we can help those with cancer instead of sending you to the private sector. So we come in, St. Anne's, Diego Martin, Port of Spain. Where you want the Maxi to stop next? Let me stop in Mount Hope. You remember under Kamala what the media used to call Mount Hope? They used to call it Mount Hopeless. You realize you don't call it that again? Because we turned Mount Hope around. You know what is the biggest problem we faced when we came into health in 2015? Anybody help me? What was the biggest problem facing health? Maternal mortality. Mothers were dying in our hospitals at the rate of 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 per year. And the media used to call it Mount Hopeless. Mount Hope is no longer Mount Hopeless. It is a center of excellence recognized around the world in how to bring down maternal mortality, in how to bring down infant mortality. We did that. We did that. Where you want the Maxi to stop next? We're going to stop in the constituency of Tunapuna. Who from Tunapuna here? Let me see all the Tunapuna people. We will be opening and starting up another palliative care center in Cora for those people with end-of-life challenges dealing with things like cancer. A new palliative care is when you comfort people in their last days, manage their pain. We'll be opening that in December of 2020. Tunapuna, you can look forward to that. So the Maxi picking up steam. We head in east. Where you want to stop next? Let me stop Arima. Arima tonight, Sangre Grande. Ah, God, all I know this song. So Arima, we will be opening, your Prime Minister will be opening the new Arima Hospital, 150 beds by around January or February of 2020. That is development. With that will come more jobs, more opportunities. We'll need more doctors, more nurses, more wardsmaids, more attendants, more human resource people, sustainable jobs. But what is Kamala offering you? Life sport. Anil, that is the offering. Compare us to them. So reject the vision of Tupal for the East-West Corridor, please. Reject that. That is Kamala's vision. This is our vision for the corridor. Jobs, opportunity, better healthcare, and are not done. Because after we go back in the Maxi, we head in further east. And where you want to stop next? You want to stop Sangre Grande. I see the MP for Grande here. Give her a round of applause. Grande, your old hospital, we just opened a brand new $5 million CT scan room. When we came into office, the CT scanner in Sangre Grande was down for a year. A year. You had to send people from Grande to Mount Hope to get a CT scan. Them days done. Your government, with oil not at $94 like Kamala for 5 years, with oil depressed, with gas prices depressed, we open for you in Grande a brand new city suite. It's beautiful. It's sweet. It's lovely. It's lovely. But we ain't done with Grandy yet. Grandy is getting a brand new 110-bed hospital that we just turned the sod for. Oh, God, if that is not progress, I don't know what is. Construction jobs again. And then when we finish, technical jobs, nurses, doctors. So we finish St. Anne's, Diego Martin, Port of Spain, Mount Hope, Arima, Cora, Grandy. We ain't done yet. Maxi ain't done yet, you know. We driving and we going? Toco. We going Toco. We going Grand Rivière. We going Matlot. Because you have not been forgotten by this government. You have not been forgotten. For the first time in the history of this country, you have an enhanced dental capacity in Toco. In Toco. For the first time, you can get your ultrasounds done where? In Toco. For the first time, you will get your x-rays done where? In Toco. So you don't have to come to Grandy. You will get it where? In Toco. But I ain't done yet. We have built new quarters for the doctors and nurses in Grand Rivière. Because in those country areas, you have to have accommodation. So the doctors and nurses are where? On site to deliver healthcare when you need it. That is what we are doing. For the first time, you will hear that. So that, my friends, is the vision for the corridor. I want to ask you, the UNC vision for the corridor is what? Tuple, failure. The PNM vision is what? Construction, jobs, then permanent jobs. Which one you want? The UNC vision for the corridor is what? A return to life sport. And don't forget, somebody lost their life in life sport, eh? A man was murdered in his bed over life sport, right? You want to disrupt the social fabric of the corridor. We are offering you opportunity in a law-abiding, sustainable way. Which one do you want? And they call it the one corridor thing. Well, I want to tell all of you tonight. Let me turn it from one corridor into one cut tail. Not what Ollie was going to say, eh? So from one corridor, give them a one cut tail. The last thing, Kamala Prasad Bisesa is offering you Anil Roberts in the corridor. We are offering you Dr. Keith Rowley. Who you prefer? Who you want? I want Dr. Keith Rowley in the corridor. That is who I want. So ladies and gentlemen, that is what we have done. And that is where we are going with health. But I want to leave you with one thing before I go. And I'm going to take Kamala Prasad Bisesa to task tonight. Kamala Prasad Bisesa got her trolls on social media, a group called Kick Out the PNM, to talk about H1N1 epidemic and how we're hiding data. Right? Prime Minister wanted to listen to this. This is the data of the deaths of H1N1 taken from CAFA, Trinidad Public Health Laboratory. Let me read something for you tonight. Because you see, on Friday, Tim Gopisig is going to come to move a motion, importance. And he will get to read it and put it on the Hansard. 9 out of 10 times the speaker will say no and I don't get to respond. I'm going to respond to Tim tonight and I'm going to send this to the media. 2016, number of reported deaths due to H1N1, zero. 2017, number of deaths, zero. 2018, number of deaths, seven, which I told the public last year. Let me read you the figures for 2013, 2014, and 2015, and let me see who lying to the country. Under the data column for 2013, you know what is the figure? Number of reported deaths, data unavailable. Do you know what that means? It means they hid the data. 2014, Number of reported deaths, data unavailable. 2015, number of reported deaths, data unavailable. So who hiding? Who fooling the country? For 3 years, they suppressed the data on the number of people who died due to H1N1. But you're calling on me now to say we hiding information. So how many people died in 2013? 100? 1,000? How many people died in 2014? 50? We don't know. Because why? Remember, with Kamala, if the seas are calm, it's Kamala. Anything good happens, Miss Kamala. I want Kamala to tell me tonight why you hid the data. Why was data unavailable 2013, 2014, and 2015 under your stewardship? Why did you tell public officers to hide data? And I have been sitting on this since 2015 because I don't want to politicize health. But I'll tell you something. When Tim Gopi Singh comes with his motion on Friday, I'm pressing click, and this report is going to the media so they could see it and ask Kamala, Kamala, why did you suppress the deaths in 2013, 2014, and 2015? We have nothing to hide. It's only when we came in we were transparent. But Kamala, you hid from the country how many people died under your stewardship. You have failed, and you have failed spectacularly. So ladies and gentlemen, as I leave you, it's an absolute pleasure to be here in Tunapuna. It's an absolute pleasure to be on the stage with my Prime Minister. It's a pleasure to be here with Esmond. It's a pleasure to be here with Camille. And as I leave you, make sure, as Pandit G said, we are at crossroads. And if you take God off your thoughts and vote for the UNC, we are in problem. So we have our young standard bearers. Support them. Come out and support them. So on the night of Monday, the 2nd of December, we will sing in one voice, one beautiful PNM voice. Great is the PNM. Great is the PNM. Great is the PNM. And we have prevailed. Thank you very much. May God bless each and every one of you. And may God bless Trinidad and Tobago.